Welcome, guys. First of all, connect your DATS V3 to your PC and then download the DATS software. Make sure that your volume at 100% and the output device is the USB audio codec, which is the DATS V3. Next, perform the test leak calibration by shorting the leads of the wires, going to the impedance analyzer, short lead calibration, and then hit OK. Wait for the result, and then you have your calibration for the test leads. After that, you have to do the impedance calibration for the resistor by attaching the leads to the pins in the DATS V3. And then going to the impedance analyzer, impedance calibration, then you hit OK and wait for the result. And that's all. You have calibrated your DATS V3. You don't need to do this calibration again. It'll be saved. Now I will get the TS parameters and the data that I need for this driver, which I don't know anything about. I'll connect the leads to the driver. We can see that this driver doesn't have a hole in the back or a port, so it's okay to put it on the table. But if yours does have a port, then you have to support it to let that port breathe. Now you want to go ahead and press on measure free air parameters. After that, you're going to get your impedance curve and a bunch of other data. But we're not done yet. We're going to use the added mass method to calculate the other missing parameters. Basically, you will need an object that you know its mass. I will use a scale and clay. I'll use a small chunk of clay, measure its mass, and then place it on the center of the driver and make sure that it sticks very well. Not to the limit that destroys your driver, but, you know, just be careful. I have measured my clay and it is 6.4 grams. Make sure that the added mass method is selected in the DATS software and enter your mass. Now you'll need to measure the piston diameter of your driver. The way that I do it is from the outside diameter to the inside diameter of the driver. You can see it very clearly in the video. It turns to be 46 millimeters for me. I will enter that in the DAS software and the piston diameter tab, as you can see. Now I'll place the clay on the driver, make a stick without damaging the driver. Be careful. Now you want to go ahead and press on measure VAS or VAS, and that's it. You're going to get all the TS parameters that you need and the like all the parameters that you need for designing the driver for an enclosure or something, whatever you need. And one last thing that I have forgot to mention is that place your driver on something that will not resonate, a cloth or something, it'll be better. And also make sure that you're in a quiet environment. There's no noise that can affect on the measurements. And that's all. See you again in the next video, maybe. I don't know. Thank you.